Hey guys, I'm Haejun from Hanshi, and today I'm back with some phrases that you could use when you are sick. And as you can tell, yes, I am suffering through a severe cold and my voice is really weird, but please try to understand. My sick voice is actually going to help you guys understand this one phrase that I'm going to teach you today. So let's get right to the lesson. First phrase we're going to learn is 감기에 걸리다. 감기, cold. 걸리다, you catch a cold. 감기에 걸리다. So in this case, 에 describes an abstract point of what you are trying to refer to. So here, 감기에 걸리다 means 걸리다 to catch what? 감기, right? You're specifically pointing at that one subject in order for you to describe what you caught. 감기에 걸렸어요. Or 감기에 걸릴 거예요. It's awkward for you to even say, I'm catching a cold in English, right? The second phrase we're going to learn is 열이 나다. 열이 나다. It means to have a fever. So 열 means heat. 나다 is a verb that means to occur or to arise. And for this phrase, you see that particle 이, a subject particle. And usually in Korean, you know, in some cases, you can omit particles. So you could say 열이 나요 or 열 나요. And for this phrase 열이 나다 or 열 나다, you can use this in present, past, future. Present, 열이 나요. I currently have fever. 열이 났어요. I had a fever. 열이 날 거예요. Oh my, I will have a fever. The third phrase we're going to learn is 머리가 아프다. Or 머리가 띵하다. 아프다 can be used with all of your body features. Again, this particle 가, subject particle, can be omitted as well. 머리 아프다 or 머리가 아프다. This can be also used in present, past, future. 머리가 아파요. I have a headache. 머리가 아팠어요. I had a headache. 머리가 아플 거예요. I will have a headache. Then how about 띵하다? It's another adjective for you to say that your head bangs or it's so dizzy. So let's imagine you have a big bell in front of you and you hit it with a stick and what do you see? The bell ringing, the bell banging, right? That's how your head feels. Your head is so dizzy. This phrase can only be used in present tense. 머리가 띵해요. The fourth phrase we're going to learn is 코가 막히다 or 코가 맹맹하다. So in present tense, 코가 막혀요. 코 막혀요. Past tense, 코가 막혔어요. 코 막혔어요. Oh, that's me right now. Oh, man. Now, there's another phrase, 맹맹하다 is how I sound like right now. 코가 맹맹하다. It means your nose is so stuffy that your voice and everything, it sounds like it's echoing inside your throat. 코가 맹맹하다. You see that sound? The fifth phrase that we're going to learn is 목이 아프다, 목이 붓다. 목 literally means neck in Korean, but at the same time it means your throat. So when you say 목이 아프다, it means you have a sore throat. This phrase can be used in present tense, past tense, future tense. 목이 아파요. 목 아파요. 목이 아팠어요. 목 아팠어요. 목이 아플 거예요. 목 아플 거예요. You can use the future tense when you sing too much, when you karaoke too much. And 목이 붓다 means your throat is swollen. 붓다 literally means to swell. And you can use this phrase in present tense, past tense. 목이 부어요 or 목이 부었어요. The last phrase we're going to learn is 몸살이 나다. It means to have a body ache. So this word can be further described as you had a cold, and because you had a cold, your body is so tired and exhausted that your body feels so chilly and your body aches so much. And this phrase can only be used in past tense. past tense. 몸살이 났어요. 몸살 났어요. Now, these were some phrases that you can use when you're sick in Korean. Please don't get sick, especially in this beautiful weather. I'm really upset that I am. But in case you're sick, these are some phrases that you can use. And next time, I'll be back with my normal voice. And until then, have a good one. Bye!